This is much better video. I'm sorry, the ones before are terrible. It's like looking at I'm not sure what happened. Maybe this is it, you know, maybe this is it. This is, yeah. Meet her. She's the lady in the green, the green hue is there on the internet. That's it, you know, that's congratulations, you're having a relationship now. Congratulations. Wow. Yeah. Oh, you can see my pearls. They're really pretty ones, huh? Yeah, they you call it. They're more of the pink. And luster is really spelled L-U-S-T-R-E. I apologize for transposing it to E-R. It has been bothering me for like the past 24 hours. It's like, I spelled it wrong. Yeah. Anyway, I don't know, I was going to talk politics or something tonight. I was like, we have politics, and I have to update France, and, you know, the nouveau journal, avec Thérèse. qu'est-ce que c'est avec la reine? Where did she go, you know? Oui, la reine de France. Oh my gosh, Dallas, Texas. Now she's in Dallas, and she's eating corn chips. Terrible. You know, they have them there also. They have Doritos, the corn chips. You can move there and just be the fat American also. It's really easy. Yeah, it's getting easier. They've made the big American pies, the apple, pomme de terre. You know, I saw the pies go from just the regular size, shape, just like, I don't know, what is that, about 6 inches, 7 inches pies, to just gross size. Here it is, like the gross, like a pizza. The pizza, apple, pomme de terre. Is that, no, pomme de terre is I'm so sorry. The pomme, not the terre, that's the one with the potato. Yeah, now I'm getting a quailism. So no, it is the one that is just the pomme, l'air, from the tree, pomme de lézard. Yeah, those ones. So the pies went drunk, 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 drunk. And the people are getting fatter. The people are getting fatter. La Reine de France. No. La largesse existe. Yeah. It's terrible. So, you know, and you're looking at the old modern times, you know, le vieux temps avec le jambon de pays, which is, oh my gosh, you know, that ham with the saltpeter, that one, they ate this, and they didn't get fat. And then they had the wine all the time. They didn't get fat, but now they're in the beer. Yeah, a lot of beer drinking is going on. A lot of the young have switched to drinking beer instead of the wines. And so I think they're getting gross beer bellies. They're eating also still the jambon de pays, and then they're eating the American grand pomme dessert, you know. So they don't even have to go to the patisserie any longer. So they don't have to stand in line at the patisserie. They just go to the big monster store, and at the big monster store, they buy the grandiose patisserie. So they're getting fat. just like the Americans. Yeah, la même de les Americans, American. Yeah. So anyway, my pearls are really pretty. Yeah. I don't know what to say about it, but I'm really happy for them. And I never really got to enjoy them this much. My oldest brother gave them to me a long time ago, before he was in that motorcycle accidents. My brother was in so many motorcycle accidents. I believe the last one he was airlifted out with a helicopter. I forgot to tell you people this one. So if you ever talk to Rene, he has been in airlifted out in a helicopter. So I believe he's not the same as he used to be, personally. But he was the brother who took me as a gift when I was 12 years old, and he had my ears pierced. That was a gift. He wanted his only sister, his younger sister, to have earrings. And so he took me to the mall. Oh my gosh, it was that mall. It was MJB Center. It was the mall where it was not known, put it this way, there was a mall that was not known for taking your pure daughter to have her ears pierced, but he did it anyway because it was cheap, and and it was great. And he did get in trouble. He got in trouble for the action. He got in trouble. But I had ears pierced after that, and they weren't going away. So he's always been like a provider for my jewelry. Many years, again and again, he's been giving me these pearls. There was a place called the Pearl of the Orient, the Great Pearl. I think it was called the Great Pearl. Oh gosh, what was it called? It was out there at Ghirardelli Square, and it was in the back corner there. And they had some really, really good pearls available. He was always great for this situation. My other brothers are not really givers of jewelry. It's interesting, isn't it? Givers of jewelry. One was a giver more of the clothing. I had one that gives me the gloves and like beautiful sweaters, but not the earrings, not the jewelry. And then I have a other brother, who, funnily enough, my younger brother, who gave me the lingerie. And so that was always unusual. I'm like, what, you giving me the lingerie? How could a younger brother be giving me lingerie? You know, that's like too sexy. You know, you're not supposed to give your sister lingerie. But he has given me one of the most beautiful brassieres I ever owned. So yeah, very thankful for that, because I had a brassiere, a pretty one. Who knows? It was a French brassiere, so it probably was one of the reasons I went to France in the first place, to go see more of them, on for sale, whatever. So it's interesting when you have brothers, because they pick and choose, don't they? They're what they're after. You know, one goes for the jewelry, one goes for the clothing. The leather gloves from my second oldest brother there, always buying me leather gloves, suedes or leather, and very thankful for that, and like cashmere sweaters and all of this, and the other one, the lingerie. That is so funny. It is so funny, actually. Anyway. What was I talking about? Nobody bought me shoes. Not one of them bought me shoes, actually. Not ever. That's interesting. Yeah. No shoes. Oh my gosh. And your brothers bought you. Yeah. It's way way too silly. It's way too silly when you think of it. But that's how different they are. That is how different, you know. Yeah, just says something about their personalities, doesn't it? And I guess that's politics also. I mean, just there are those three men. That, you know, if you take each one and you say they are a country unto themselves on the planet, each one, you know, just says about their politics. One chooses the jewelry, the other chooses the clothing, and the other goes for the lingerie. I mean, that's different politics right there. You know, just from three men that are in the exact same family from the same mother and father, it's ridiculous. Absolutely. Yeah. So we're all like, oh, fighty over the politics of this place or that place. And yet, at the end of it, I start to think, well, when we have within our own families such a tête-à-tête or whatever, absolutely, you know, fights over, you know, this ridiculous, I'm a conservative, or I'm Republican, or I'm this liberal, you know, all of this going on. Ugh, I have like this wonder, if they're doing all of these things, you know, with such almost aggression as, you know, almost as much aggression as, they don't have the ballistic missiles at each other, however, they're still talking this way, they're still, you know, fighting this way, you know, you get alcohol involved also, it does become like, what is going on, you know, just chill out about the entire thing, who cares, you know, but it doesn't end up being this way, does it? Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, the tales of the three countries there are just right there in your own brethren, your own sibling brothers. That can be something good for the women to look at as a kind of a wake up that you know, we're always drawn into these politics as we're gonna fix it. Well, maybe we have to look at our families and all of their differences first, you know, to realize that fixing, you know, it's almost like personalities, you know, we've got different personalities we're dealing with, you know, and we're just, I don't like that personality, I don't like this personality, that's all, it's personalities, just like the guy in North Korea likes to march a lot, you know, it's his deal, he loves the discipline. They love that discipline.